माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नेक्स्ट कॉम्पाउंड नेम इज बहुव्रीहि समासः। बहुव्रीहि समास, फर्स्ट यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द डेफिनेशन, हाउ यू अंडरस्टूड अबाउट तत्पुरुष। तत्पुरुष मीन्स डिफरेंट डिफरेंट वर्ड्स। फर्स्ट वर्ड विल गो टू डिफरेंट विभक्ति, सेकेंड वर्ड विल बी इन डिफरेंट, एंड वेन यू डू कॉम्पाउंड the first word will drop its linga vibhakti vachanam according to sandhi, join with second word, that is tatpurusha, which vibhakti tatpurusha. And then we discussed dvandva samasa, 1+1 2 1+1+1 3. So whatever last word, it's dvivachanam or bahuvachanam. In there we discussed three difference: itaretara dvandva, samahara dvandva, combine, ekashesha remaining similar word. Now we'll go to bahuvrihi. My dear students, in this bahuvrihi samasa, when you see the compound, here first word, second word is not important. Through this you will understand third word. I repeat, first word, second word. Of course, we have to do expound between these first and second. But through this compound, you are going to understand something else, some different word. So for the different word, when we are doing expound, that is called bahuvrihi. That's why I wrote here anya pada pradhanaha. Through this compound, I repeat, you are going to understand different word, different meaning. Example, shall we go? Dashananaha, patthu talai. If you say patthu talai in Tamil, patthu talai, when you say, immediately the Ravana comes in our mind. That is called bahuvrihi. Yavan uruvanukku patthu talai irikkirado avan Ravanan. Like that in Tamil we are explaining. Same in Sanskrit. Dashananaha means ten headed. When you say ten headed, automatically we are not concentrating these ten headed. We are jumping to that particular noun who is called Ravana. That is called bahuvrihi. Therefore, anya pada pradhanaha. Through this compound word, you are going to understand some different meaning, some different. That is called bahuvrihi. Example. And okay, in this bahuvrihi, you have to concentrate. You should have knowledge of yat shabda, tat shabda. Slowly you go. Yat shabda, tat shabda. You know why yat and tat? Which, that. Now this which, you do not confuse with an English question mark. Which is the book? There which is the question. What kind of book? When you say which, that. Who, the boy one who, there, he. So that he, that kind of connectivity word is there, right? That kind of which word. Which, that. It is not question. So you can't go to prashnavachaka padam, you should go to yat shabda. In Sanskrit, which means yaha yau ye, yam yau yan, yena yabhyam yehi. This is pullinga. Feminine, ya ye yaha, yam ye yaha, yaya yabhyam. Then napumsakalinga yat ye yani, like that, sahataute, satetaha, tatetani. So which and that, these two words are very important in bahuvrihi expound, to do bahuvrihi expound. Okay, then what to do? How you are going to conclude yat shabda, tat shabda? Yat shabda will go to different vibhakti, but the tat shabda is going to tell perfectly that particular noun or whatever, it is what gender, what vibhakti, what vachanam. Simple example. Dashananaha. I am just writing dasha. I am just orally. Then I told you in my class, my dear students, orally you have to listen again and again. When you are able to grasp that, then I will write on the board. Then you focus. That's all chapter clear. You will understand. Now I am just telling dashananaha. When I say dashananaha, your mind is ready to accept this is masculine gender. So masculine gender means saha, 100% end of the expound, saha will come. Okay, now we go, sir, in which vibhakti? Yat shabda will go to different vibhakti. Because what is the meaning of dashananaha? One who is having, in English when you say have, has, had, in Sanskrit you should go to Shashti Vibhakti. One who is having, yavan uruvanukki irikkirado, avan. See, uruvanukki irikkirado. So one who has, he is called Ravana. For the example, you go again, dashananaha. What is the meaning of dashananaha? Ten headed, ten heads. Or so ten you have to first expound. Dasha, anana. So when you say dasha, automatically it goes to plural. I am sure ten is not the singular. One is singular, two is dual. From three, everything comes under plural. So ten comes under after three. So ten means plural. So dasha, anana. Anana means face in Sanskrit. Ananam. Gajananam. Gajananam means one who is having elephant face. Who is Lord Vinayaka? Pullayar. Gajananam. Now, dasha, ananam you should not tell. You know why? Because when dasha you used in plural, ananam should go to plural. So, anana shabda neutral gender. Ananam, anane, ananani. So, dasha, ananani. Yes, you got, you expound dasha, ananani. Now, what is the next thing? You should remember yat shabda, tat shabda. One who has 10 heads. And I told you had and has shashti. So, yat shabda go to shashti. And dashananaha is masculine. So, yat shabda should go to masculine. Yaha yau ye, yam yau yan, yena yabhyam ye hi, yasme yabhyam ye bhyaha, yasmat yabhyam ye bhyaha, yasya. So, dasha ananani yasya. Yes, you got it. Now remember, dashananaha ends with the masculine gender, prathama vibhakti ekavachanam. Then tat shabda pullinga prathama vibhakti ekavachanam is saha. So, dasha ananani yasya saha. This is called expound of dashananaha. And name of the expound or compound is called bahuvrihi samasa. Bahuvrihi means, my dear students, just relax and understand. Okay, bahuvrihi means through this word we are going to understand something else. Now you take for the example, of course, dashananaha, we are just for short form we are calling dashananaha, but we are describing his physical, right? 10 heads. No one will keep name 10 head. One who has 10 head, Ravanaha is his name. Like that, Shurpanakha. Shurpanakha, of course, they are calling that Ravana's sister Shurpanakha. But name one who has nail like Vinay, Muram. In Tamil, we are telling Muram, right? Vinoy. One who is having a nail like that. That is Shurpanakha. So first, we'll go to dashananaha. Dasha ananani yasya saha is equal to dashananaha. Now we'll go to some different word. First, I'm just writing here. I will start from here. Dasha ananani yasya saha. When I wrote this, my dear students, you will get answer. Dashananaha. Now please focus. Why I wrote saha? I wrote saha because the compound is ending with pullingaha prathama vibhakti ekavachanam. And pronoun of tatshabda pullinga prathama vibhakti ekavachanam saha. Then your next question. Sir, why you wrote yasya? Please go to the meaning. What is the meaning of dashananaha? One who has head. 10 heads, one who has. So, Shashti Vibhakti. So, yasya. And what he is having? 10 heads. Heads. So, ananam, anane, ananani. And 10, dasha. So, if you go reverse order or this order, you will get clear picture. Dasha, ananani, yasya, saha, dashananaha. Another word. There is one word, prabhuta salilam. But remember, they will not give only that particular one word. They have to give sentence. Then only you will be able to understand through this sentence what is the real meaning. Now I am going to write different one more sentence where I will show you the Bahuvrihi compound. Example, Pavitra Salilam. Or Pavitra, yes, we can write. Or Prabhuta also we can write. Pavitra means pure water. Prabhuta Salilam Saraha Asti. My dear students, they will give sentence like this. Prabhuta Salilam Saraha Asti. Focus the sentence. I am sure you are a Sanskrit student, so you are able to understand. Asti means is, present tense. Saraha means pond, kolam in Tamil, talab in Hindi. So saraha means pond, there is a pond. Okay, one adjective for that pond. Describing that pond, what, which word? Prabhuta salilam, plenty of water. You just go in English. Plenty of water pond is there. This is the sentence. A kind of funny sentence. Plenty of water pond is there. That is why I told English we don't have this kind of facility. Here in English you have to explain there is a pond in which plenty of water is there. Plenty water pond is there. Wrong English. Of course, you want to describe that pond, in which pond, plenty of water. That pond, I am seeing that pond, in which pond, plenty of water. But yeah, see that, which, that, that's why I told you. Yat and tat, yat means which, that means tat. I am seeing that pond. What kind of ponds are? That pond in which plenty of water is there. In which, in Saptami Vibhakti. In which, so which Shabda will go to Saptami. And that ends with neutral gender Ekavachanam. Because Saras Shabda, it is a neutral gender. Saraha, Sarasi, Saramsi. Now I am going to expound in which plenty water. So I am just going Prabhutam. Salilam. Got it? Now you may think, yes, yes, aha. No, 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 no. Please see what kind of preposition. In which, so Saptami Vibhakti. Yaha yau ye, yam yau yan, yena yabhyam yehi, or yatiye yani, from Tritiya, same. Yena yabhyam yehi, yasmai yabhyam ye bhyah, yasmat yabhyam ye bhyah, yasya yayoh yesham, yasmin. Yasmin, that means, in which, plenty of water, that, what is that? Pond. In which you got. Now that pond is used in Prathama Vibhakti, Ekavachanam. But my dear students, please relax. This Saraha look like Ramaha, but it is not a masculine gender. It is feminine. Sorry, it is neutral. Tat te tani. Like that Saraha, this is a Sakaranta Manashabda. Manaha manasi manamsi, like that saraha sarasi saramsi. So prabhutam salilam yasmin tat is equal to the word, the answer is prabhuta salilam, this compound. For this compound, just see how I explained the expound. Again, you put question to yourself. Sir, why you use here yasya? Why here yasmin? You will get answer. Here yasya means one who has 10 heads. One who has. Here yasmin, in which. See how I am changing the prepositions. And of, has and have, has had everything, Shashti Bhakti. In, on, at, among, this is Saptami Vibhakti. So, Prabhutam Salilam Yasmin Tat Prabhuta Salilam. So, my dear students, just focus if Prabhuta Salilam. What is the name of this compound? Anyapada Pradhanaha. By that compound, you will get some different meaning. So you are not talking about plenty of water. You are telling there is a, you are not telling there is a plenty of water. Just see the sentence. You are telling there is a pond. And what kind of pond? Where there is a plenty of water. In which pond? Plenty of water. So Prabhuta Salilam is not main. It is describing the Saraha. And through this Prabhuta Salilam, when we are able to understand Saraha, so this Prabhuta Salilam is just putting light on that Saraha. Therefore, Anya Pada Pradhanaha. Here these words are not important. Through this word, we are understanding this particular word, which is called Saraha. And Dasha Ananani, yes, like that if you go, you can see Ravanaha Dashananaha Asti. So Dasharanaha just telling about Ravana. We are not going to discuss about Dasharanaha. We are going to talk about Ravana. That this Dasharanaha describing the Ravana. So where Anya Pada Pradhanaha, where through that compound, we are able to understand some different meaning. That is Bahuvrihi. We just go to Dvanda Samasa. Dvanda Samasa we discuss Pitarau Agachataha. I told if two boys are telling, fathers are coming. Yes. One boy is telling, parents are coming. Direct their parents. Pitaro means parents. Or two boys means each different fathers. Rama Lakshmanau Gachataha. Direct. Rama and Lakshmanas are going. Direct. But Prabhuta Salilam is not direct. We are just, this Prabhuta Salilam is describing the pond. That means, Yatra Anya Pada Pradhanaha, where we are getting through the compound different, some different meaning, describing the different word, that is called Bahuvrihi. And in this Bahuvrihi, you know, you will get the different example. One more example will go, and then I will conclude. Shubhanana. That is why I am telling this expounder compound, come in sentence. All the compound exponent comes in sentence only. That's why you have to apply the method. Shubhanana Kanya Gayati. Please focus. I just create this sentence. Shubhanana. Expound. Before doing expound, focus. What is the meaning? Shubhanana Kanya Gayati. Just go word by word. Gayati, singing. Kanya, a girl. Kanya Gayati, sentence over. A girl is singing. What is the Shubhanana? One more extra. That particular word which is describing the girl. Shubhanana means one who is having beautiful face. So when you say Shubhanana Kanya Gayati, a girl is singing. One who is having beautiful face. Just go. So you have to go beautiful face. One who has. That. Got it? Like 10 heads. One who has. Here masculine. Because Ravana. Sir, how you understood this is feminine? Just see. This is Kanya. Kanya means girl. Of course feminine. So you have to break this Shubhanana. So first word is Shubham. Next word you have to break, face, ananam. Okay, you no need to go. That question will come, sir, shall I go ananani? My goodness, a girl, one who is singing, she is having only one face. So therefore, shubham, ananam, stop. Go, the meaning, one who has. So, yasyaha, you may have doubt, sir, excuse me. Sir, why yasyaha used? But your students focus. Because this word is describing the girl. And yasyaha yat shabda shashti. Yaye yaha. Yam ye yaha. Yaya yabhyam yabhihi. Yasye yabhyam yabhyaha. Yasyaha yabhyam yabhyaha. Yasyaha shashti. Here yasya. Masculine. That is the difference. Easy to expound because see the word is describing girl, therefore yasyaha. Sir, why you conclude sa? Because only one girl. प्रथम विभक्ति कन्या कन्या कन्ये कन्या सो इट्स फेमिनिन जेंडर तत् फेमिनिन जेंडर प्रोनाउन तत् शब्द सा ते ताः सो सा सो शुभम आननम यस्याः सा शुभानना फॉर दिस शुभानना दिस इज कॉल्ड एक्सपाउंड देयरफॉर इन बहुव्रीही सी 10th standard CBSE, they have only limited exponent. There are so many exponent compound. My dear students, do not shrink your mind. According to 10th syllabus CBSE, Bahuvrihi Samasa, this is Bahuvrihi. When Bahuvrihi comes in your mind, you should know that particular compound is going to tell something else. Example, beautiful face, when comes in your mind, automatically you are not waiting that beautiful face. You are thinking that beautiful face, who? Either boy or girl. Yes? So beautiful face, we are not analyzing. We are going through that something else. Therefore, Anyapada Pradhanaha. And we discuss Dashananaha and Prabhuta Salilam, example for pond. And Shubhanana, beautiful face, adjective for girl. So through this, we are understanding the girl only. And we expound Shubham Ananam Yasyahasa. This is called Bahuvrihi. So before concluding Bahuvrihi, my dear students, please remember, to understand Bahuvrihi Samasa, you should have a knowledge of Yat Shabda and Tat Shabda. Without Yat Shabda, Tat Shabda, it is not possible to do expound of Bahuvrihi Samasa.